The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, 9th chapter, text number 11 through 14, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded in October of 1966 in New York.
Abhajananti mang murha, manasim tanumasritam, parambhava majananta, Mamabhuta Maheswaram. So, Lord Krishna says that the murha means the foolish, just like animal, or less than animal, an ass, he is called murha. So, abhajananti means derive at me. That any person who does not believe in God, he must be either a madman or a foolish man, number one. Any person who does not believe in God. There is no reason that we cannot believe in God. There is every reason. So, suppose if you are saying that I don't believe in God. But who has given you this power to say that I don't believe in God? You are speaking, I don't believe in God. But as soon as there is something, you cannot speak, everything stops. So who has given you this speaking power that you dare to say that I don't believe in God? Would you not think that how I am speaking? Who has given me this power? Do you mean to say that this speaking power has come automatically from the stone? This body is just like as good as stone. As soon as the speaking power is withdrawn by the supreme authority, you are as good as stone, this body. What is the meaning of this body? So who has given you this speaking power that you are now denying that I don't believe in God? Therefore, if an atheist or an unbeliever, he must be a first-class foolish man. There is no other reason that one can deny the existence of God. It is very simple reason. So who has given you the power to talk and who, if he withdraws the power from you, then what is your value? How can you boastly say that I don't believe in God? This very power of speaking is the proof that there is the greatest authority who gives you everything. Therefore, the Krishna conscious person, he knows that everything whatever I have got, it is under my control. The controller is different. I am seeing. I am simply using it. I am talking. This is my hand. I am working. But if the power of working is immediately withdrawn, it is paralyzed. Have you got any power to revive this working power of this hand? No. You are not. One hand will work, another hand will stop. Who stops? So these things have to be taught. Now how can I deny? There is something. If I don't believe in God, but I must believe some power beyond me, which is controlling me in every step. So either call you God or anything, nature, but there is a controlling power. You have to admit. How can you deny it? Therefore, anyone who denies the existence of God, he is a foolish man. He is not a very intelligent man. No intelligent man will deny. So Krishna says, abhajananti mang murha. Manasim tanumane. Krishna is saying here, because he was present on this earth just like a human being with some supernatural power. But mostly 99% of people, they could not recognize it. Could not recognize that he is the supreme power of, supreme personality of God. Param bhavam ajanam. Because they have no eyes to see. There are, how we can recognize God? Some supernatural power, evidence of authorities, scriptural evidence, these things are required. So far Krishna is concerned, every authority has accepted him as God. And when he was present, his activities were superhuman. And from the evidence of Vedic literature, he is God. Then, in spite of all these evidences, if you don't believe him, then it must be considered the asuri bhav, that I shall not believe whatever evidence you give and whatever, activities you may show, I will never believe you, God. Then there is helpless. So, avajananti mangmulha manusim tanumasuta. Besides that, one must have the eyes to see God also. God cannot be seen without imperfect senses. So the whole bhakti process, bhakti yoga, is the process of purifying the senses to take, to understand what is God, what is spirit, what is soul. It requires sarvapadhi vininmaktam tatparatena nirmalam anukullena krishnanusilam bhakti uttama. And in the Narada Pancharatras, we have sarvapadhi vininmaktam tatparatena nirmalam rishi jena rishi kesa sevanam bhakti uchyate. Simply, the bhakti yoga is the process of purifying. As soon as you purify your power of seeing, power of hearing, power of tasting, power of touching, all these we have got our senses to taste, to acquire knowledge. But if the senses are blunt, then we cannot understand what is God. But therefore it requires a regulative principle to understand what is God. That regulative principle must be undertaken. And the most easiest regulative principle is this chanting of Hare Krishna. If you regularly chant with devotion, without any offense, then this very simple process will help you to purify your senses and you will appreciate presence of God and God consciousness, Krishna consciousness will develop in you. The param bhavam ajananta mama bhuta maheshwara. People, they do not know what is the inconceivable power and potency of God. Therefore, they think God might be as somebody like me. They cannot understand God.
Moghasa mogha karmanu mogha jnana vichetasa rakshasim asarim chaiva prakritim mohini srita.
So, why they cannot understand? Then moghasa. Moghasa means whatever they are aspiring, whatever they are desiring, that will be baffled. Moghasa. That's the karmi. Karmi means the primitive actors. They are always hoping something better. There is no limit where they will stop. So much money, so much bank balance, so much money, so much stake. So, moghasa, mogha means they are hoping to be very happy at a certain point, but that point never comes. That point never comes. Moghasa, this means moghasa. Because he does not know what is the ultimate point of my satisfaction. Nate vidu sarthagatim hi Vishnu durasayaji bahiratthamani. People, they do not know who are enamored by the external beauty of this illusory material energy, they cannot understand that what is the aim and objective of life. They cannot understand. Therefore, moghasa, moghakarmana. Moghakarmana means fruitless, baffled. Whatever they are doing something, but at the end they will find it is frustration. They are not happy. Take for example, we have practical experience in India. Mahatma Gandhi, he was a great worker for national emancipation. You have heard his name. But at the end, he was so much disgusted that I have seen personally, wherever he used to go, he used to plug his ears like this. Why? Now, wherever he'll go, thousands of people will gather and will cry, Mahatma Gandhi ki jai. So the poor fellow could not sleep in. The person, as soon as there is some sense that Mahatma Gandhi is coming here, at least 5,000 people will gather and will cry, Mahatma Gandhi. See, at the last stage of his life, he could not sleep due to his crying. Just see. And he was so much disgusted, the very morning when he was, assassinated, he was killed by bullet shot, he said to his secretary, I'm so much disgusted, I wish to die. You see, this very word was published in the paper. Now see, such a big worker, such a sincere worker, but still he fell baffled. And what to speak of others? The moga karma. Unless we become Krishna conscious, then all our activities will be baffled at the end. Take it. What Krishna is saying, not an ordinary person like me. Krishna, moghasa moga karma, no? Moga jnana. Moga jnana. Jnana means research of knowledge, philosophical speculation. So, without Krishna consciousness, without this definite point, now, if you have got sufficient knowledge, if you have such power for research, now here is the point that Krishna is the Supreme Personality of God. Now, make research work whether Krishna is not God. Then your research work will be sufficient. But without any point of aim, without any objective, what is this? Thousands of years, simply speculating. Panthastu koti satavasya sampragamma vayurathapi manasu manipungavana jappa sappasya japrabhadasimna avitintatasti govindamadi purishantamaham bhajami. Govinda, the Supreme Lord, he is so vast that you cannot reach him by your mental speculation. Panthastu koti satavasya. Koti means 10 million. And koti satavasa, similarly, millions and millions of years, with the speed of air and with the speed of mind, if you proceed to speculate, to understand the Supreme, that is not possible. That is not possible. So many speculators at the present moment or in the past, Speculating, they never reach the point. There is not a single instant that they have reached the point. So this speculation process will also not help. Moghasa, moga karmana, moga vichetasaha. Vichetasaha means they are bewildered. That God cannot be perceived by your own endeavor unless God reveals before you. Vichetasa. Vichetasa means bewildered. Just like if you want to see the sun, can you see the sun just at this time, all over darkness? Have you got any machine or any apparatus or any searchlight? You can show me sun? No. It is not possible.
See, if you cannot see at night with your own endeavor, even a material thing like sun, do you think that by your own endeavor you will see God? How it is possible? As the sun reveals in the morning at 5 o'clock or 6 o'clock, similarly, when the sun, Krishna, will reveal before you, then you will understand. You cannot find out Krishna or understand Krishna by your own endeavor. Now that process is this Krishna consciousness. Sarvadhanman paritajimamekam sarvam. You will be in confidence. Tesam satatujuktanang bhajatang pritipurvatam. Those who are taking this line with faith and love, all is engaged in the transcendental loving service of Krishna. Buddhi yoga dadamitam, then from within, Krishna is within you. We have no realization. Due to my material conception of life, I have no realization. So you have to realize that Krishna is there. And you have to purify yourself by service attitude. Then Krishna will be here. We'll see eye to eye. Mogasamogo karmana mogo. Rakshasi masarin chaiva prakitin mohinstita. Rakshasi. Rakshasi means those who are atheists, they are called rakshas. Rakshas and asura. Asura, they are always against God. They are called asura. And rakshas means they don't believe in God. Chak rakshasi asarin chaiva prakitin. Why that? Then mohini prakitin, they are bewildered by this illusory material energy. They think this is all. And this life, there is no God. There is no life. Let us enjoy as far as possible. Squeeze out the extract of this matter. Squeezing the door, they are frustrated. Mogasa. Baffled in every respect. Squeezing to take a sense of this material pleasure, but baffled. Don't you see this practically? So much money, so much have earned. They go to enjoy $50,000, $100,000. Squeezing, they do not find any pleasure. Simply squeezing. Mogasa, mogasa. That is not the process to find out real pleasure. If you have to find out real pleasure, then you have to take to this Krishna consciousness. You have to be trained up in this Krishna consciousness. Then you'll have to change your habits in this way. You'll find ananta, ramante, yogina, anante, unlimited happiness, which will never end. Never end. Namante yogina anante satyanant. That is real happiness. That does not end. Don't you see? Is there happiness in the material world, in your sense enjoyment, which does not end? It begins and ends. Say for few minutes or few hours or few. Okay. The real happiness has no end. That is real. That we have to search. And for which? You have to undertake some voluntary payment. You are then just trying to get the unlimited happiness and you are not prepared to sacrifice anything. What is that sacrifice? You have to sacrifice little time. Come here and hear this Bhagavad Gita and chant with us. Is it very great sacrifice? And you will learn everything. Just to sacrifice little time. In former days, they used to sacrifice their whole life for realizing self-realization. Devam Rindra Guhyam. In the demigods and great saintly persons, they sacrificed everything. Still they are unsuccessful. You see? Now for this age, Lord Chaitanya mercifully has given you so much easiest process for God realization. There is no comparison.
simply to sacrifice a little time. Shravana, simply here. You haven't got to pay any charges. Shravana, simply you have to sit down a little patiently and hear. You'll realize. It is such a nice thing. Lord Chaitanya therefore recommended this process. In these days, no process will help you for self-realization. But this process, Dhane sthita sutigatam tanumanga manovi, if you be situated in whatever position you are, it doesn't matter. We are not going to inquire what you are. Are you a businessman, engineer, doctor, or foolish, or intelligent, or educated, non-educated, black, white? There is no question. No question. The only thing is, the sthane sita sutigatang. Sutigatang means, suti means this oral reception. You have to receive this word little submissively. Namanta eva. Don't think yourself that you are man of knowledge. Because our knowledge is very limited. So we should not be puffed up with false thinking that I am very learned man. No. Just become a little gentle and submissive and hear these messages from Krishna. Sthane sthita sutigatam tanuvang manovi. Tanu means your body, and vang means your words, and mana means mind. Just try to adjust your mind, your body, your words. And here is Srimad Bhagavad Gita, which is spoken by the Supreme Lord. And put your arguments, put your reason, whatever you have got, don't accept it blindly and think over it, and then you'll see what is the reason. This is Rakushin. But in spite of all these facilities, the Lord says, the Rakhasin Asurin Chaiva. Those are Rakhasa. Rakhasa means almost man-eaters. Rakhasa are called man-eaters, more than tigers. They, for their self-satisfaction, they can eat, even their own sons. You see, they are called Rakhasa. No sense. My sense gratification should be satisfied. Never mind, you go to hell. So this is the age. So we create a machine that everyone comes and become smashed in that machine, and my sense satisfaction is there. Although I'll never be happy by that sense satisfaction. This is going on. You can know. This world is now managed by the Rakhasas. They don't mind what is happening. They are prepared to sacrifice everything for fulfilling their whimsical nonsense. They are called Rakhasas. Rakhasas asurin chaiva prakitim mohinti. Why they are very much enamored by the material beauty. Not beauty, the material civilization. So they cannot understand. It's very difficult for them. They cannot understand. And they will never try to understand. Because they are Rakhasas. Then, who will understand? God, Mahatma, anastamang prakta devi prakitim aptitaha. Bhajanti anannamane. So, kyatta bhutadi mabhayam. And here is, those are Mahatma. Mahatma means one who has enlarged his heart. Enlarged his heart. Oh, everything belongs to God. I also belong to God. He is Mahatma. Mahatma anustu maang prattha. My dear Arjuna, these Mahatmas They are not in under the control of this material nature. One who can think that everything belongs to God and I also belong to God, therefore the supreme proprietor is God, everything should be engaged in his service. This is the qualification of Mahatma. Brother, God is great and his heart is also has become great for serving the great. He is Mahatma. Mahatma not a stamp, a political leader, Mahatma. Don't misunderstand. I stamp you, Mahatma, by votes. And you become God, you become Mahatma. Now these are not accepted in Bhagavad Gita. Mahatma's description is there. The Mahatmanastumang Partha. Devi Prakriti Mahasrita. He has taken the shelter of the superior spiritual energy. As we have discussed many times, God has got many energies. Parasa Sakti Vividhaivasyate. There are unlimited energies, different varieties of energy. Out of that, those who are in the knowledge, they have divided the whole energy into three divisions. What is that? Material energy, spiritual energy and marginal energy. This material energy you are seeing and the spiritual energy now you have no knowledge. But the marginal energy, something spirit, something matter, that we are. We living entity. I am as I am spirit, but I am mixed up with this matter. Therefore I am marginal energy. Between spirit and matter. I am combination of spirit and matter. As soon as I am spirit, I am away from this matter, this body becomes matter. That's the word, that's the beast. Yes. So, those who are Mahatma, they have to take shelter of the spiritual energy. Of course, for God, every energy is His energy, therefore He has no distinction what is spirit and what is matter. But for me, because I am in marginal energy, I have to make distinction that this is spirit, this is matter. So, Mahatma, those who have broadened their heart for becoming Krishna conscious or devoting himself for the service of the great, just like to one, a government servant, important government servant, he also becomes important. Similarly, God is great and when you are engaged in his service, you become great. You become great. That is called Mahatma. So as soon as you take shelter of the spiritual energy of the Supreme Lord, at once you become Mahatma. Mahatmanastumang prartha devi prakriti maasrita. And suppose now I was identified with the greatness of the Supreme. Aham Brahmasmi. This Vedic word is called Aham Brahmasmi. I am Brahma. But simply being part of I am Brahma, I become God. That is another rakshasi, another misleading. Here it is said that if you have become Brahma, then you must show your activities in Brahma. Because you are spirit, you are not inactive. To become Brahma does not mean that I become inactive. Oh, in matter I am so much active because I am Brahma. Although I am contaminated with matter, still I am so active and when I am purified from matter, do you mean to say my activity stop? What is this reason? By nature I am active. By nature, because I am spirit, by nature I am active. And my activities are exhibited even I am contaminated with this matter. And when you become purified from matter, do you think you shall be silent? Is there any reason? So to become Brahma does not mean to become bhai. No. To become Brahma means superior energy. With superior energy, we have to work with superior endeavor and superior energy and superior position. And that will be taught in the next life. Bhajanti Ananna Manaso. One who has become Mahatma, his symptom is that he is fully engaged in the loving transcendental service of Krishna. He is Mahatma. How can you stop activity? Bhajanti Ananna Manaso. Gyatta Bhuta Adimabhyam. Why does he engage in that way? Because he understands that if service has to be rendered, it is to Krishna and nobody else. I have so long served my senses, now I shall serve Krishna, the proprietor of this. That is Dharma. You cannot stop your service because you are meant for service. Can you show anybody within this meeting, anybody who does not serve? Is there anybody who does not serve anybody? Go outside, ask hundreds and thousands of people that don't you serve anybody? You go to the president, Johnson, ask him, don't you serve anybody? Well, yes, I'm serving the country. So who is out of service? Nobody is out of service. But he's serving the illusion. And as soon as he serves the Supreme, he becomes Mahatma. Service you cannot stop, but you have to stop your service to the nonsense, but you have to give service to the reality. Then you become Mahatma. Mahatmanastumam prasthat. Daimi prakriti mahatsita. They are under the influence of the spiritual energy. They are no longer under the control of this material energy. So, Mahatmanastumam prasthat. Daimi prakriti mahatsita. Bhajanti ananna manasu gyatra bhutadimabhyam. He transfers his service potency to the Supreme instead of serving the false, instead of becoming baffled. Always he wants to make some asset in his life by serving the Supreme. And how that service begins? Now that is also stated here, you see. Satatam kirtantam maam jatantasya dhirambhata. This kirtan, always chanting, glorifying. That is the beginning of Mahatma. So you come here, you chant, become Mahatma. Thank you very much.